I welcome you back to the presentation on analysis of determinate structures. In the last class, we had finished some basic discussions connected with the concepts of influence line diagrams, how we normally try to draw influence line diagrams for various internal forces like bending moments, shear force, reactions. We had also used it to find the value of reactions and bending moments for some simple cases. Today we shall try to talk about application of the influence line diagrams to simple numerical examples and analysis of simply supported beam carrying single moving concentrated wheel loads and analysis of simply supported beam carrying moving UDL longer than span, again using influence line diagrams. If you recollect, in the last discussion we had said that when you have one single wheel load acting on the beam, the appropriate desired quantity, it could be the reaction or the bending moment or the shear force, can be determined by taking the product of the intensity of the load multiplied by the ordinate in ILD right under the load. But when we have more than one wheel load, that is multiple wheel loads acting on the beam, we try to extend this particular concept in the sense that the desired quantity, it could be the reaction or bending moment or shear force, can be determined by taking the algebraic summation of the product of intensity of each load multiplied by the corresponding ordinate in ILD under each load. That is, we try to say that internal force is nothing but sigma, algebraic summation of Wi into Zi. What is Wi? The number of loads that is acting on the beam, and Zi is the appropriate ordinate in ILD, okay, right under the loads. Now if you have UDL, that is the load which is distributed over some distance on the beam because of the track vehicles, again the desired quantity can be determined by taking the product of the total load, okay, that is, say for example you got 10 kilonewton per meter spread over 3 meters, the total load would be 10 into 3, that is 30 kilonewton, and that has to be multiplied by the average ordinate in ILD under UDL. That is, when we consider the UDL, the influence line diagram, there would be two ordinates in ILD, one to the left of 30, that is the UDL, and one to the right of the UDL. We try to take the average value because the variation of ILD in case of determinate beam is always linear. So this is how you can do it. But another simpler way that we can try to do is, we try to say intensity of UDL multiplied by the area in ILD under UDL. Both will give you the same thing, but I would be normally using the second option, that is intensity of UDL multiplied by area in ILD right under UDL. Now let us take some simple example. So before that, I think I would like to make a small important discussion, that is difference between BMD or SFD and influence line diagram. Now what you have right now is, okay, a simply supported beam which is carrying some load W, okay, at C. Now when you just try to talk about BMD, okay, so BMD for this position of the load in a simply supported beam is a triangle, and the value of bending moment right at C is WAB by L, which everybody knows. Now just try to check this distribution. Please understand, this diagram tells you how the bending moment varies from section to section. At each section, how is the bending moment? present over the entire length of the beam. So that means, okay, this shows you the entire pictorial representation of the variation of bending moment right from A to B at all sections, okay, for this position of load. That's what we mean by bending moment diagram. It gives you an overall picture of the distribution of bending moments at each and every section present when the load is at C. Similarly, if you just try to look at the shear force diagram, so the shear force diagram again for this particular case, okay, tells you how the shear force is varying from section to section, okay, over the entire length of the beam when the load is positioned at C. So because you need to understand clearly the difference between the influence line diagram and the bending moment diagram or the shear force diagram. Shear force diagram and bending moment diagram gives you how the bending moments and shear force are distributed at each and every section right over the length of the beam for a given position of load. But if you just try to look at the influence line diagram, it is drawn for a section. Okay, this entire diagram, whatever you have drawn, is for section C. That means what we understand by ILD is, okay, this diagram gives you the variation of bending moment only at C. Okay, when the load moves from A to B, when this unit load, okay, moves from A to B. Right? I hope trying to understand. This diagram, whatever we are trying to show you, is how the bending moment is going to vary only at C. Okay, that means we need to first understand, okay, at what section we are studying. Okay, so this ILD always gives you the variation of a quantity. That means it could be reaction, it could be bending moment, it could be shear force at a particular section when unit load moves from one end of the beam to the other end of the beam. So I think we have seen how we use this particular diagram. That means, okay, so for example, if the unit load is at C, okay, so the bending moment at C is nothing but the value of the load, that is unit load, multiplied by the ordinate right under C, that is AB by L. Right? So this is how we try to use the influence line diagrams to calculate the appropriate quantity. So please understand, ILD is drawn always for a section. Now let me just try to take you through one simple example, okay, to start with. This is again, okay, the ILD for shear force. This is again, this entire ILD tells you how the shear force is going to vary at a given section. Okay, when the unit load moves on the beam right from left to right. So please understand, ILD is always drawn for a section, given section. Now let me take you through one example. Okay, assume that, okay, the load is a moving load and right now combination of concentrated and UDL. Right now it has stopped at some instant like this, and we want to calculate a few quantities, okay, for this position of load. Right? So strictly speaking, assume that right now the load is stationary, and for this stationary load, okay, on this beam, we are trying to calculate the reactions at A and B using ILD. That's a small change. So I hope you know how to calculate the reactions at A and B using the equilibrium equations in the conventional sense. You apply sigma m about point A equal to 0, you get vertical reaction at B. You apply sigma Fi equal to 0, you get vertical reaction at A. That is not what we are doing right now. So what we are trying to do is, for the same load, we are trying to use influence line diagram and we are trying to calculate the reactions, okay, at A and B. Now if you just try to look at this particular figure, so what I have done is, I am interested to calculate the reaction at A. If I want to calculate the reaction at A, I have to first draw the appropriate influence line diagram. You need to remember these four standard influence line diagram: influence line diagram for vertical reaction at A, influence line diagram for vertical reaction at B, and influence line diagram for bending moment at a given section C, and again influence line diagram for shear force for a given section C. Now what we are talking about is influence line diagram for VA. So obviously the section is at A, so always it is a right angle triangle. Okay, the maximum ordinate is at A because you are talking about reaction at A. So the maximum ordinate is at A, and the reaction at and the ordinate at B is 0. The variation is always a straight line, so it's a right angle triangle. Okay, the length of the right angle triangle is spread over the entire span. Okay, first draw the appropriate influence line diagram. Now having understood this, then we try to calculate the ordinate right under the concentrated load. So the ordinate in ILD below the concentrated load is 0.6. How this is calculated? So at the span is 5 meters. So at 5 meters, it is 1. The ordinate is 1. At 3 meters, what is the ordinate? So it is 3 by 5 into 1 is 0.6. Okay, so that's how you try to calculate this value, ordinate. Now, whenever we have concentrated loads, we try to calculate the ordinates. Whenever we have UDL, I hope you understand, we need to calculate the area in ILD below the UDL. The UDL is spread only from C to B. So I have to calculate the ordinate or find the area, right, in ILD only from C to B, which is nothing but this shaded portion. Right, now how do I calculate the reaction at A? It is intensity of load, that is 40, multiplied by ordinate in ILD under load, which is 0.6, plus intensity of UDL, that is 20, into area in ILD under UDL, which happens to be a right angle triangle, half base height. Half base is 3 meter, height is 0.6. So I just use this simple calculation. 40 into 0.6, that is 40 is the concentrated load, 0.6 is the ordinate, plus intensity of UDL 20, area, half is 0.5, base is 3 into 0.6. So I just try to sum it up, 24 plus 18, that is 42 kilonewtons. So I hope you're trying to understand. It's very simple to calculate reactions or any other quantity using ILD. You don't need to do it in conventional sense. So this is how you have calculated the reaction at A. So now we have to calculate a reaction at B, for which we use an ILD which is almost mirror image of this. So let us start. Now I am trying to calculate the reaction at B, for which you use an ILD, appropriate ILD. The appropriate ILD for vertical reaction at B is again a right angle triangle. Now the ordinate at B is 1, the ordinate at A is 0. The variation is a straight line. So this is how you have to use this. You have to use this ILD to calculate the reaction at B. Now there are different types of load, two types of loads acting on the beam. One is concentrated load and another is the UDL. So for concentrated load, I have to calculate the ordinate in ILD right at point C. So I get this as 0.4. How did I get this? So that means at 5 meters length, it is 1, ordinate is 1. At 2 meters, what is the value? It is 2 by 5 into 1, that is 0.4. So that will be used for 40. But for 20, I have to calculate the area under the UDL. So the area under UDL in ILD looks like this, that hatched portion. Now it has become a trapezium. Last time it looked like a triangle. Now it is looking like a trapezium. So I have to calculate the area of the trapezium and multiply it by the intensity of UDL in this case. So we try to calculate the vertical reaction at B as what? Intensity of load, that is 40, multiplied by ordinate, under that is 0.4. So the first term would be 40 into 0.4. The second term is due to UDL. Intensity of UDL is 20. Okay. Then the area of this. How do I get area of a trapezium? Average of the ordinates on the left end of the UDL, the ordinate is 0.4. On the right end of the UDL, the ordinate is 1. We take the average, that is 0.4 plus 1 divided by 2, or 0.5 into 0.4 plus 1, multiplied by the distance between the two ordinates is 3 meters. So into 3, that leaves the area. So you just try to multiply and simplify. You get 16 plus 42, that would be 58 kilonewtons. So this is how you try to calculate the reactions, okay, in a simply supported beam using ILD for any given load. Now let me just try to go to the next exercise or problem, where we are trying to take a simply supported beam, again same beam subjected to same kind of load, but here we are trying to calculate the bending moment at a given section, say C. So we want to find the bending moment at a given section. Please understand, the first focus should be where you want to calculate the quantity, which quantity you want to calculate. Okay, and then we talk about the load. The first thing that we are trying to talk about is, okay, bending moment at C. So we have to draw the appropriate ILD. So that means I have to first draw ILD for bending moment at C. How does the influence plane diagram for bending moment for a given section looks like? It looks like a triangle. So the apex or the peak of the triangle is right at C. Now this C divides the section or divides the span into two parts, that is 2 meters and 3 meters. The span is 5 meters. Okay, left hand side, this is small a, is what we normally abbreviate, and this is small b. So the value of small a, that is the length of the or the distance to the left support from C is 2 meters. B is distance to the right support from C is 3 meters. So the ordinate is calculated as A into B by L. So A is 2 meters, B is 3 meters. So 2 into 3 is 6. 6 divided by span is 5. That is 1.2 and this is 1.2. The first thing is, okay, don't worry about the load. First draw the influence line diagram for bending moment, the appropriate quantity at C. So it looks like a triangle. Now, okay, look at the loads. What are the loads we are trying to have here? We have again two loads. One is 40 kN, another is UDL of 20 kN per m. Okay, so whenever we have concentrated load, we have to make use of the ordinate in ILD, okay, right at that point. So please understand, okay, this load of 40 kN is acting right at C. So the ordinate under that is 1.2, already we have calculated. Now for UDL, this UDL is spread from C to B. So we have to take the area of this portion of the triangle, that is to the right of C in ILD. Okay, so just try to check, I have hatched. Okay, so this is the portion. Okay, I will be hatching that particular portion. So the way we calculate bending moment is the same as the way we calculated the reactions. So the same formula, intensity of load multiplied by ordinate in ILD under the load, that is for concentrated loads. For UDL, it is intensity of UDL multiplied by area in ILD under UDL. So that means that hatch portion is what I would be considering right now. So the bending moment at C, M suffix C, is nothing but 40 into 1.2. That is, when you have concentrated load, you have to just take the ordinate. When you have got UDL, intensity of UDL, that is 20 multiplied by area, okay, in ILD right under the UDL, that would be a triangle here. How do you calculate the area of the triangle? Half base height, half is 0.5, base is 3 meters, height of the triangle is 1.2. Simplify, 48 is due to concentrated load, 36 is due to UDL. So the sum of that is 84, which is nothing but the bending moment which occurs at C. So the value of bending moment, okay, at C due to this position of load on the beam is 84 kilonewton meter. So I'm trying to understand, okay. So we've used a different type of ILD for bending moment. So you use different types of influence line diagram for reactions. So but whatever it is, every time the way we make use of the influence line diagram is the same. There is equation on the right hand side of the equality is same. Intensity of load multiplied by ordinate in ILD under load plus intensity of UDL multiplied by area in ILD under UDL. So this is how we have calculated the bending moment. If you are doing the same problem in conventional sense, first you would have calculated the reactions using the equilibrium equation, and then you would have taken, okay, the calculated the bending moment at C by either taking the algebraic summation of moments either to the left of the section or to the right of the section using the appropriate sign convention, that is sagging moment is positive, right? We are not doing any of that, okay, here. Now coming to the next, another example to introduce you to the third influence line diagram, that is shear force. So for the same beam, again I am asking you to, we are trying to discuss how we are trying to calculate the shear force at C. So as you have guessed, now I am using a different shear force ILD diagram for shear force. How does a typical influence line diagram for a shear force at C look like? Okay, it looks like this. So you want to calculate the influence line diagram at C. So right at C, we have got two ordinates. Okay, first draw the baseline, okay, covering the entire span. And at C, there will be two ordinates, one above the line, one below the line. And this ordinate is right at C. Now the ordinate below the baseline and above the baseline depends on the value of small a, which is nothing but distance AC, and small b, that is distance CB. So please understand, C can be given anywhere. So depending upon where we are considering C, the values of small a and small b will change. Correct? So the ordinate below the baseline is nothing but a by l. Okay, this distance, that is 2 meters divided by span, that is 2 by 5 is 0.4. So this ordinate, okay, this ordinate is 0.4. Now the ordinate above the baseline, okay, same position, is b by l. What is b? Distance, okay, CB. Here it is 3 meters. So 3 divided by 5 is 0.6. Please understand, the summation of the two ordinates, a by l plus b by l, is always equal to 1. Okay, because as you can understand, a by l plus b by l is nothing but a plus b by l. A plus b is l itself, so l by l is 1. So the value of the ordinates above and below the baseline depends on where you are trying to consider C. If you are trying to consider C anywhere to the left of the midspan, okay, the value of A is always lesser than B, in which case the ordinate below the baseline is always lesser than the ordinate above the baseline at C. However, if you are trying to take C to the right of the midspan, anywhere to the right of the midspan, so obviously small a is always larger than small b, in which case the ordinate below the baseline is always more than the ordinate above the baseline at C. Further, another important thing that you need to observe here is the sign of these two ordinates are different. All ordinates in this portion are treated as negative, and all ordinates in this portion are treated as positive. So unlike the previous two cases, in the previous cases, that is when we calculate the reactions, whether it is VA or VB, vertical reaction at A or vertical reaction at B, or the bending moment, okay, all ordinates were considered to be positive. Whereas here, in this ILD, please understand, okay, the ordinates, okay, in this portion of ILD below the baseline are negative, and the ordinates in this portion of the ILD, that is above the baseline, are all positive. So if you are using ordinates or area in this portion, it has to be taken as positive, and if you are trying to take ordinates or area in this portion, it has to be taken as negative when you are trying to calculate the relevant quantity. Now let us try to use this to calculate the shear force at C. Now shear force at C is calculated as what? Intensity of load multiplied by the ordinate under the load. Okay, and we have got UDL, it is intensity of UDL multiplied by area, okay, in ILD under the load. Now in this discussion, please understand, okay, at 40, the load 40 kN is acting at C. Now at C there are two ordinates, one is 0.6 plus 0.6, and the other one is minus 0.4. okay, so same point, there are two ordinates. Now please understand, okay, which one you are going to consider is what you may be wondering. Okay, so generally, please understand, we can take combinations here. Okay, that means you can take 40 with minus 0.4 and do calculation once, okay, along with 20 and this area. Okay, and the next one would be 40 with plus 0.6 and 20 multiplied by this area. So whichever is larger is the one that we normally try to consider. Okay, so we would always want to calculate the maximum value of shear force for this position of the load. Okay, so you can always try to do some rational thinking and then try to understand which one, which ordinate will try to help me to get the maximum value of shear force at C, okay, for the given position of load, okay, and for the given section. That's what you have to normally understand, think, and then try to do it. If you cannot understand, you can take both cases, take the larger of the two, and then try to say that's the maximum SF that we can have, okay, for this particular loading. Now in this particular case, as you can understand, okay, as for UDL, we are trying to take all positive ordinates. Hence I will be also trying to take, okay, a positive ordinate of 0.6 for 40 kilometers. So we just try to check here, the calculations go like this. 40 into plus 0.6, I'm not taking minus 0.4, plus intensity is 20 multiplied by area in ILD under the load, which is again a triangle, area of the triangle as half base height. There is 0 plus, please understand, it's plus, not minus, plus 0.5, base is 3, and height at this point is 0.6. Simplify, you get 24 kN shear force at C due to 40 kN and 18 kN shear force, okay, at C due to 20 kN UDL, put together as 42 kN. Okay, I hope you have understood, okay, how we can use ILDs, okay, the four standard type of ILDs to calculate the reaction at A, reaction at B, okay, then the bending moment at a given section C and shear force at a given section C. Okay, this is just to introduce you to the concept of ILD. Now let me just try to take you through, okay, so different examples. As I mentioned in my earlier presentation, okay, we will be dealing with five standard loads in simply supported beam. There is single concentrated V load, okay, the first one that we are trying to take, followed by moving UDL longer than span, then moving UDL smaller than span, then two concentrated V loads spaced at fixed distance, and then the last one, multiple V loads which are spaced at fixed distance. So let me start with the first type of analysis. That is nothing but analysis of simply supported beam carrying single concentrated moving V load using influence line diagram. So we are not trying to do this problem in the conventional sense, okay, like using the equilibrium equations. We are using influence line diagrams. The problem, whatever I am starting, is a very simple one, so that you get a feel of using influence line diagrams again for single V loads, and which can be extended to the problems where we try to deal with multiple V loads. Now the problem reads like this: a single concentrated V load of 40 kN. The value of the V load is 40 kN. It crosses a simply supported beam of span 8 meters, say from left to right. If the direction is not given, we always assume it's going to cross the beam from one end to the other end. I'm assuming it to cross the beam from left end to the right end. Now we are trying to calculate the reactions at supports when the load is at 3 meters from left support at some given position, right? As you can understand, when the V load moves from A to B, it will be occupying different positions, okay, at different instants of time, okay, and finally it moves out of the beam. It moves out of the beam, correct? So at some instant, it is at 3 meters from left support. So when the load is at that position, we would like to calculate what is the reaction at A, what is the reaction at B. Further, we would also want to calculate the bending moment and shear force, okay, at same section, 3 meters from left support, when the load is at a different position. That is, when the load is 5 meters from left support. Is it all right? You are trying to calculate the quantity, bending moment shear force, at a different section, but the load is present at a different section. And finally, third one, absolute maximum of bending moment at the given beam. That means, okay, when the load crosses, okay, the beam, okay, so each and every section will experience different maximum value of bending moments, okay, and the section which experience the maximum of all these maximums is called as absolute maximum bending moment. So which section will develop the maximum bending moment, okay, when the load moves over the length of the beam? And the last one, absolute maximum shear force in the beam, okay, so which section again will develop the maximum shear force, okay, when the load moves from left to right. Okay, we are using influence line diagram. So let me start with the first one. Okay, so we are trying to calculate a reaction at support A. The first thing that you need to understand here is, okay, you have to first draw the appropriate ILD. That means, okay, I will draw ILD for vertical reaction at A. How does an ILD for VA look like? It looks like a right angle triangle. Okay, so the value of ordinate at A is 1, the ordinate at B is 0. I am drawing for VA, hence the ordinate at A is 1, the ordinate at B is 0. The variation is a straight line. First, you have to draw this triangle. And then we need to understand where exactly the load is kept. The load is kept at C. Okay, that is, we just try to check. Okay, now the load will come and sit at sea. This is where the Lord is trying to be placed. Okay, so this is at some instant, okay, Lord is here. At different instant, the Lord will further move and take a different position. So we are trying to take one position, and the position that we are trying to take is, look, the Lord is at 3 meters from left support. Okay, the very first thing that we do right now is, having identified the Lord, you have to first calculate the ordinate right under the Lord, which would be 0.625. How do we calculate this? Simple. What is the total span? 8 meters. So at 8 meters, it is 1. Ordinate is 1. At 5 meters, what is the ordinate? So it is 5 by 8 into 1 is 0.625. First, calculate the ordinate. Now, once you have calculated the ordinate, okay, so I hope the next calculation is very simple. So vertical direction, it is intensity of load multiplied by ordinate in ILD under the load. You should always multiply the ordinate under the load. So you should always calculate, okay, the ordinate right under the load. So it is just 40 into 0.625 will give me 25, and this is nothing but the reaction developed at A. Okay, when the load is positioned at C, that is 3 meters from left support. Right, so we are not trying to use conventional sense like equilibrium equations, okay, and then try to calculate the reaction. Okay, it is as simple as this. So we'll repeat this for support B. Right, in support B, correct? So first thing is, we have to draw the appropriate ILD. How do I draw the appropriate ILD? It's again a triangle. Where is the maximum ordinate? At 1. At B, that is 1. Okay, what is the ordinate at B? At A, 0. How is the variation? Straight line. So it's again a right angle triangle. Okay, we just turn the right angle triangle. So this gives you the influence line diagram for VB. So the next question is, okay, where is the load position? Okay, we have said load is positioned at C, 3 meters from, okay, left support. Correct? So the moment you just try to say, okay, let's try to put the load at C, 3 meters from left support. Having placed the load at C, we have to calculate the ordinate at C in ILD. How do I calculate this ordinate? Again, simple. At 8 meters, the span. Span is at 8 meters, the ordinate is 1. At 3 meters, what is the ordinate? So it's nothing but 3 by 8 into 1 is 0.375. Okay, we have got the ordinate. Once you've got the ordinate, we are using the expression. What is the expression we are trying to make use of? So vertical reaction at B is intensity of load multiplied by ordinate in ILD under load. There are different ordinates. I am not using any of the ordinate. I am using the ordinate which is present right below 40, that is 0.375. And this is, you have to calculate using similar triangles. So 40 into 0.375 will give you 15 kilonewtons. Please understand, in this particular expression, I am not talking about any UDL, because the beam is not carrying any UDL. Okay, the beam is carrying only single concentrated wheel load. So I am just trying to do the calculation only for that. If you quickly recollect, okay, the reaction VA we had got was 25 kilonewton. The reaction we have got now is 15 kilonewton. So that means when the load 40 kilonewton is placed at C, okay, reaction at A is, we have got already earlier, 25 kilonewton. The reaction right at B, which you are trying to see here in this calculation, is 15. So 25 plus 15 is 40 kilonewton. Okay, total downward force equal to total upward force. I hope you have understood this, right? So this is how you try to calculate the reactions, okay, using ILD in this problem. So let us now go to the next exercise. The next exercise is about calculating the bending moment at a given section. The first thing that you have to understand is where the section is. Now the section is defined as 3 meters from left support, correct? So this is what we are trying to say. Okay, the section is 3 meters from left support. So draw section C here, 3 meters. Now once you have identified this as 3 meters, the right distance is 5 meters. Why? Because the total length of the beam is 8 meters. The total length of the beam is 8 meters. This distance is given as 3. Obviously, this will become 5. Then we have to draw the influence line diagram. the influence line diagram for bending moment is what we are going to write in this case, because we are calculating bending moment in the beam. Correct? Which point at C? So this is the focus point that we have here. So this ILD is drawn for C. Correct? So whatever we try to calculate here in this problem, we'll try to tell you what is the bending moment at C only. It is not BMD, it is not SFD, it is nothing but ILD. And how do we calculate this ordinate at C? A into B by L, AB by L. What is A? 3 meters. What is B? 5 meters. What is L? 8 meters. So 3 into 5 by 8, that is 1.875. You are writing this as 1.875. So the very first thing that you do, this is, I hope it's quite simple. First identify the section. Once you identify the section, you know what are A and B, to distance to the left and distance to the right. Okay, then draw the ILD. ILD is always a triangle having its peak at C. So the peak coordinate is calculated as AB by L. Okay, you finish off this quantity, this one to begin with. Next, you place the load. Now please understand, okay, it has been said that load is at 5 meters from left support. Okay, so 5 meters from left support is nothing but 2 meters beyond C. So this is where you are placing the load. Okay, load is at point D. Once load is placed at point D, the first thing that we have to do is calculate the ordinate in ILD right under the load. How do I do this? Simple. So at 5 meters, this distance, 5 meters, the ordinate is 1.875. At 3 meters, what is the ordinate? I use similar triangle concept. 3 by 5 into 1.875 will give you this value, 1.125. Correct? So you got the value of ordinate at D in ILD. You have to always calculate ordinate right under the load in ILD. So once you have done this, I do my simple calculation. That is, bending moment at C, when the load is at D, correct, is equal to intensity of load multiplied by ordinate in ILD under the load. So it is 40 load multiplied by corresponding ordinate, 1.125, which will give me 45 kilonewton meter. Please understand, okay. So whatever value calculated is the value of bending moment which occurs at C, okay, when the load is at D, right? If you just try to push the load elsewhere at a different point, the ordinate will be different. Correct? As you are trying to push it away or towards the support, the ordinate keeps reducing and the value of bending moment at C keeps on reducing. When the load is right at B, the ordinate is zero. There will be no bending moment. The beam does not bend. So 40 into 0 is the value of bending moment at C. Right? So again, when the load is at A, ordinate is 0. So when the load is at A or B, correct, the bending moment at C is always 0. So when it starts moving towards C, correct, the ordinates keeps on picking up. Okay, and you can understand that at C, bending moment is maximum when the load is right at C, because okay, when you just try to take this product, intensity of load multiplied by ordinate in ILD under load, only ordinate keeps on changing, right from 0 to 1.875 and again from 1.875 to 0. To make max beam at C, you have to use max ordinate. To use max ordinate at C, you have to position the load at C itself. This is what you need to understand. Correct? So simple logical thinking, if you can understand, you can do this kind of problems. Now again, I have to calculate what is the shear force at C. Okay, when the load is again at 5 meters from left support. The very first thing that we have to understand here is, first draw the ILD for shear force at the section where you are trying to calculate the shear force. So section is defined, which is 3 meters from left end. So this is small a. So this is L minus small a, which is B. That is 5 meters. Total span is 8 meters, this is 3 meters, this has to be 5 meters. We draw the ILD for shear force. How do you draw the ILD? First draw a base line, horizontal line. Then at C, you have to draw a line which has two ordinates. Ordinate above the baseline, ordinate below the baseline. For the given position of C, small a is less than small b. This distance AC is less than distance CB. So obviously the ordinate below the baseline is smaller than ordinate above the baseline. What is the ordinate below the baseline? A by L, 3 by 8, 0.375. What is the ordinate above the baseline? B by L, that is 5 by 8 0.625. next, join the two ordinates to the ends by a straight line. Okay, and again, as I told you, this is the positive region, that is the negative region. So this is how you plot the influence line diagram for shear force at sea. Now, having drawn this, the next thing that we are trying to talk about here is, okay, so find the value of shear force at sea when the load is at some given point. Okay, so load is positioned at D right now. When the load is positioned at D, what is the shear force that we get at sea is what we are trying to calculate. So again, it's a very simple calculation. So the way in which we are trying to calculate, every time it is the same. That is, it's nothing but, okay, shear force at sea is intensity of load multiplied by ordinate in ILD under the load. What is the intensity? 40. What is the ordinate? Plus 0.375. It is 15. So for shear force, you have the sign convention, correct? Okay, so that means, okay, the shear force can act upwards or downwards. Okay, so whatever sign convention, okay, that we are trying to get is based on, okay, the positive sign, okay, that we are trying to get in this particular case. Is it all right? Okay, so like left up and right down, okay, that kind of a sign convention. So here the shear force at section C is plus 15 kilonewton, okay, is what we are trying to say. Next, we will go to the next one, that is absolute maximum bending moment of the beam. As I told you, when you say absolute maximum, it is the maximum of all maximums. Now, we just try to quickly recollect. In the last case, we have defined both. We have said where you want to calculate bending moment, that is at C, 3 meters from left end, and where the load is positioned, that is at 5 meters. When you talk about maximum bending moment, you have to understand what kind of problem this is, what kind of load is moving on the beam. And for this, where do I get absolute maximum bending moment? Now please understand, for a simply supported beam, okay, so connected with the single concentrated wheel load, absolute maximum BF always occurs at the mid-span, correct? And next, where you have to place the load? Again at mid-span, so that I get maximum ordinate in ILD. Having understood these two, okay, we can easily calculate, okay, absolute maximum BM in the beam. Okay, first we have to locate the section. Section is not given, unlike the previous problem. Here we have understood absolute maximum bending moment occurs at the mid-span. So if it is at mid-span, total span is 8 meters. So distance AC is 4 meters, even distance CB is also 4 meters because C happens to be the midpoint of a span AB. Correct? Having identified the section where we are trying to calculate, we draw the appropriate BMD. ILD for BM, influence line diagram for BM at C. Okay, how does it look like? It looks like a triangle. Where is the maximum ordinate? At C. How do I calculate this ordinate? AB by L. But what are A and B here? L by 2, L by 2. If you substitute A equal to B equal to L by 2 and simplify, you get as L by 4. What is L? 8 meters. 8 by 4 is 2. So the ordinate here is 2. Okay, the ordinate that we have is 2. Correct? It is a symmetric triangle is what you need to understand. Now the next one is, where should I position the load? Okay, the value of load is always constant. The ordinates keep changing. For which position of the load do I get maximum ordinate? That is nothing but C. If I place the load at C, I can use 2, the maximum ordinate. If I place it somewhere, I'll be using minimum ordinate. Since I want absolute maximum, I'll be placing the load right at C so that I can use this maximum ordinate too. Once you have done this, we try to calculate absolute maximum bending moment at sea is nothing but intensity of load multiplied by the corresponding ordinate in ILD. That is ordinate in ILD under the load. So 40 into 2 is 80 kilonewton meters. Now please understand, the moment you get this information, absolute maximum BM, what you need to understand here is, this is the maximum BM that is developed in the beam anywhere, okay, for any position of load. Okay, please understand that we also calculated in the previous case, okay, bending moment at 3 meters from left support when the load is at 5 meters from left support. Okay, different. If you just try to compare that bending moment with this, that will be less than this value. That will be always less than this. So this is nothing but the maximum that we can expect in this problem, and hence we call it as the absolute maximum bending moment. Okay, similarly, we are trying to calculate what is called as, okay, the absolute maximum shear force, okay, in the beam. Correct? Again, for single concentrated wheel load, absolute maximum shear force occurs either at the left support or at the right support, not simultaneously. Okay, and when does it occur? When the position of wheel load is over that support. I hope you understand. Okay, generally bending moments in simply support beam, bending moments are maximum, okay, at the mid span or around the mid span. At mid span when the load is symmetric, around the mid span when the load is unsymmetric. Regarding shear force, maximum shear force are always seen at the reactions, as reactions at the supports. Correct? Right? So, and we have to place the loads appropriately. So since it's the load is regarding one concentrated wheel load, you get the same maximum reaction either at A or at B, not simultaneously. Okay, so when the load is at A, you get VA to be maximum, and when the load starts to move down, move towards right, VA reduces, becomes zero, and VB starts to increase, becomes maximum. Okay, when the reaction, when the load is right on top of B. So I'm just trying to take one of the reactions here. Absolute maximum shear force is what I'm trying to calculate. I'm trying to tell you that it always occurs at the support. So let us first draw an appropriate ILD. I'm drawing influence line diagram for vertical reaction at A. It looks like a triangle, as you are trying to see like this. Okay, the next one is, where should I position the load? Okay, to get maximum reaction at A, okay, I have to make use of maximum ordinate in ILD. Maximum ordinate is 1, which is at A. So it is quite logical to understand that, okay, the load should be placed at A to get maximum reaction, right? And what is the ordinate I am supposed to use right now? 1. Okay, so I am just trying to do a very simple calculation here, the same equation. So that means, okay, absolute maximum shear force, okay, occurs at A, which is equal to intensity of load multiplied by ordinate in ILD under the load, which is 40. Okay, load corresponding ordinate is 1. 40 into 1 is 40 kilonewtons. Okay, so please understand, I can repeat this for absolute maximum shear force at B also, right? In which case I'll be using the other ILD. Okay, I'll be placing this 40 kN load right at B. So 40 into 1, okay, you get as again 40 kN, okay, as a reaction in B. So for this problem, okay, you get absolute maximum shear force either at A or at B when the load is positioned at A or positioned at B. So this was a very simple, straightforward problem we started with, so that you are trying to appreciate and understand, okay, how to use the ILDs for this type of loading. Okay, my next discussion would be with respect to the second type of load, that would be, okay, UDL longer than the span. Okay, analysis of simply support beam carrying moving UDL longer than the span, again using influence line diagram. So I'll be trying to take up this discussion, okay, in the next class. Okay, thank you.